Hello aspirants, welcome to Vishwam IAS Academy. Today we are going to start History NCERT book from class 6th to 8th. It is useful for prelims plus mains. So we are going to see about the important notes of history part 1. So three classes, class 6th, 7th and 8th. 6th deals with our past 1. And 7th 2 and 8th is 3. So past 1 is from chapter 1 to 12, and these are the chapter names. Let's see about the chapter 1. What, where, how and when. From our past we can study food, clothes, houses of people, even lives of hunters, herders, farmers, etc. On the banks of rivers like Ganga, Narmada, etc., people used to live in large numbers. People also began rearing animals like sheep, goat and cattle and lived in villages. People traveled from one part of the subcontinent to another through hills and high mountains, including the Himalayas, deserts, rivers and seas, made journeys dangerous at times. Men and women moved in search of livelihood, as also to escape from natural disasters like floods or droughts. Sometimes men marched in armies, conquering others' lands. Besides, merchants traveled with caravans or ships, carrying valuable goods from place to place. So, in the ships, they used to carry valuable goods. Religious teachers walked from village to village, town to town, stopping to offer instruction and advice on the way. So throughout their journey, they share their information to others. Finally, some people perhaps traveled driven by a spirit of adventure, wanting to discover new and exciting places. All this led to the sharing of ideas between people. Two of the words we often use for our country are India and Bharat. The word India comes from the Indus, called Sindhu in Sanskrit. So this is one of the important point we should remember, that the India comes from the word Indus. It is called Sindhu in Sanskrit. The name Bharata was used for a group of people who lived in the northwest and who are mentioned in the Rig Veda. That is the earliest composition in Sanskrit. It is dated to about 3500 years ago. Later it was used for the country. So this is the origin of the word Bharata that we are using now as Bar. Ways to find out past. So there are manuscripts, inscriptions, etc. Let's see about one by one. Manuscripts, these were usually written on palm leaf or on the specially prepared bark of a tree known as the birch, which grows in the Himalayas. Over the years, many manuscripts were eaten away by insects, some were destroyed, but many have survived, often preserved in temples and monasteries and few in museums too. These books deal with all the kinds of subjects, religious beliefs and practices, the lives of kings, medicine and science. So there are different aspects of book, like they deal with religious beliefs and practice and also about kings, medicines, ancient medicines like Ayurvedic medicines and science. Besides, these were epics, poems and plays. Many of these were written in Sanskrit, others were in Prakrit, that is the languages used by ordinary people, and not only Prakrit, also Tamil. Inscriptions, these are writings on relatively hard surfaces such as stone or metal. Sometimes kings got their orders inscribed so that the people could see, read and obey them. There are other kinds of inscriptions as well, where men and women, including king and queens, recorded what they did. So that is inscriptions. They used to write all the relative things that happened in the ancient time. Next, archaeologist. They study objects like inscriptions on rocks, monuments, etc. They also explore and excavate, dig under the surface of the earth to find tools, weapons, pots, pans, ornaments and coins. Some of these objects may be made of stone, others of bone, baked clay or metal. Objects that are made of hard, imperishable substances usually survive for a long time. They also look for bones of animals, birds and fish to find out what people ate in the past. So that is what we are calling now as excavation. Plant remains survive for far more rarely if seeds of grain or pieces of food have been burned. They survive in a charred form. Historians, scholars who study the past often use the word source to refer to the information found from manuscripts, inscriptions and archaeology. Years are counted from the date generally assigned to the birth of Jesus Christ, as we named as BC, AD, CE and BCE, the founder of the Christianity. That is, the Jesus Christ is the founder of the Christianity. These are some letters with the dates. BC is before Christ. AD is after death, also, that is after death of Christ. CE is common era. BCE is before common era. So these are the basics which we can easily read it and remember it easily. This is the first chapter, what, where, how and when. And the second chapter deals with all the on the trail of the earliest people. We will see that in next video. So we can post each chapter in single video. So until then, I'm signing off. Thank you.